Okay, guys, we're gonna do something totally different in this video. We are going to go through the documentary features on the new version of Hulu. So, as you can see, the screen is displayed in its own categories. Is like, let's do this. So as I go into different categories, there's different, themes to it. Like this is obviously like the crime section. As you can tell, I'll keep going down here. And they've added Unsolved Mysteries as well. American Greed, which is a good show. FBI Files. So yeah, basically, Hulu has done a wonderful job with creating categories for you, like your interests. So, and then here's another category. So this seems to be like world documentaries, things like that, and music documentaries as well, and maybe some on celebrities. Like here's the James Bond documentary, for example. So yeah, you get quite a variety of different things in here. One that I would definitely recommend watching is this one called Kurt and Courtney. It's about Nirvana. Very interesting stuff. And they have really good UFO documentaries on here as well. Again, it just it kind of depends on what you're into. There's a deep web documentary, which is kind of interesting. And obviously, there's going to be stuff that I'm not really interested in here. But that's the thing that I like about Hulu, though, is it's really for anybody. It doesn't have to necessarily be for everyday people. You can find whatever you really want to watch on it. We'll just keep going through the categories here. So this seems to be more like music themed stuff. So this would be up my alley. I would probably watch a lot of these. So yeah, there's some good stuff in here. The documentary on Michael Jackson in here is really good as well. So these are some of the ones that I've seen that Disney has done documentary wise, and I really enjoy these. Like, pretty much most of these I've seen, and they're really just the production value, and what you're getting out of it. And what you're learning is amazing. They put a lot of effort into their documentaries. A lot of ocean documentaries as well. So again, I think that it really depends on what your interest is. I'll keep going here. This is just kind of like a variety of different things that they're doing. So we'll keep going. Unfortunately, there are some that are in the same categories with other ones, which I'm not quite understanding that, but. we'll keep going here. So yeah, this really depends on your interests and what you want to learn. But you can find some pretty good stuff in here, so. These seem to be a little bit more like sports themed and a few other things as well here. This right here, A Gamer's Life, this is by far one of the best documentaries I've ever watched. It really goes into detail about professional gaming. And there's my favorite show that I watch all the time, Ancient Aliens. Honestly, I'm a person, there's a Nikola Tesla documentary in here too. I'm a person who really wants to be open-minded. I don't want to be told how to think in any form of way in my life. I'm not a person who watches a lot of news and worries about what people are doing to other people. I'm more about educating, myself by being open-minded. And I think that if people were more like that, they wouldn't be panicking about what's going on. So we're gonna go back. Okay, hang on here. So what I wanted to do real fast as well is show you guys that there's a option to be more involved in what you were selecting to watch. I'll go up to the top here. So you have action, adult animation, adventure, anime, cartoons, classic, comedy, cooking and food, which is interesting. And then you obviously have crime, documentaries, drama, family. Game shows, health, history, horror, international films, kids, and then for the lesbian and gay community, you have your movies as well on here. Late night, which is like Jimmy Fallon, Jimmy Kimmel, stuff like that. Latino, you have your Latino channel, Telemundo. Life, lifestyle and culture. Huh, they should have added, they just added that probably. Music, mystery, news, reality TV shows probably, romance, science and technology. That was something new that they recently added. Science fiction, and something more with comedy. They must have just added that as well. Sports, stand-up, teen shows, and thrillers. So as you can tell, and then you have kids, Hulu original programming. Let's actually go into that, and I'm going to show you guys the some of the original programming that's on here. So Hulu decided recently to start having their own TV shows. And I am all for that because they have had a lot of success with their programming. and we'll go back here. So what I wanted to do was kind of show you the original programming on here, and some of the shows that I actually, Casual is very interesting. I've seen it lots of times. Let's see here. Yeah, I mean, I've honestly watched the majority of all of these shows, and they're very, very entertaining. I can't say anything more. It's just something that you guys might have to check out and watch, but yeah, they have a lot of good stuff in here as far as their own programming. And here's the alphabetical category. So you basically can just search whatever you want. And as I said before, I've watched a lot of these shows myself, and I like them. I think they're pretty entertaining. And actually, there's a show right here with Kevin Smith where he and his friends review movies, and then they actually... we'll have people call into the show and they'll interview people over the phone and ask them what they think. That is really interesting, really cool that they're doing that. So yeah. For example, we'll go into the movie section here. So again, with the movies, you have your categories up here. For example, I'll just, I won't go through all the movies, but I'll kind of scroll through them. So, you know, you have movies for, like, kids, general, like, action movies. I mean, they have all different types of movies in here. They even have, like, in where is the 80s? Hang on. Okay, that's more like documentaries again. Okay. Let's go over here. They did have a section in here for 80s movies, which I'm trying to figure out here where that is. This might be it, actually. Yes, this is it. So... here are basically your 80s movies. You have Karate Kid, you have Spaceballs, League of Their Own. And then it goes more into detail, Indiana Jones, Wrath, Bill and Ted, both movies. And then definitely some other favorites as well, Black Hawk Down, Heartless. So yeah, these tend to change quite a bit, but the good part of it is you will have so much diversity to watch, that there's nothing that really blows me away yet that I've seen, but at the same time, like, here's the Disney section, they do change movies quite a bit, but you're getting a lot of diversity as far as what you are essentially getting to watch. So we'll keep going and scroll down here too. Okay. So as you can see, I mean, you're getting a lot for what you're paying to watch. I mean, I can't really complain. I mean, I feel like for the amount of money that you're paying for Hulu, you're getting exactly what you want to watch. And they're always adding things as well. I mean, there's every time I log in here, there's something new to watch. So, I mean, so we'll just scroll down here a little bit. The Crow was just recently added, RoboCop. So out of what I've been showing you guys, are you pretty impressed with the library of the movies that you get? I think that they've done a very good job at adding things. So yeah. And this is the main screen. So as you can tell, here's some suggestions of things that I've been kind of watching. Obviously, I'm a little bit different. I like watching a little bit of everything. And that is true that they have added all the episodes of Animaniacs and Tiny Toon Adventures to the library on here. So if you are a fan of 90s stuff, you've got everything you want to watch here, including Garfield and Friends. Venture Brothers, Man vs. Food, Best in the World, Fixer Upper, 30 Rock, the latest Simpsons season is on here. Saving Grace, which is a really good show. I've seen it several times. Rick and Morty. Not really a big fan of Rick and Morty. It's okay. It's not anything that I would. Step by Step, definitely. I watch that a lot. Everybody Hates Chris. Home Improvement. I Love Lucy is always classic. Will and Grace. Melissa and Joey. Seventh Heaven, which they've recently added. Futurama, big fan. Blossom is now on here, Archer, all the seasons. So we'll go into more TV. So let's go into some of the categories here real fast. Yeah, I mean, basically this is just a section where you can find your average, favorite TV shows. I mean, I don't want to go through all these shows because, I mean, the library just keeps adding and adding and adding every week, pretty much. So they get the rights to everything from science fiction to anime to just about anything, honestly. Hulu is definitely worth the money. I recommend it. It's even better than Netflix, in my opinion. So yeah, I mean, it just really depends on what you're into, what you want to watch. They've got a little bit of everything. So I just wanted to have an opportunity to show you guys a little bit of what they have, and what's coming. And here's an interesting category. So you got like all your featured shows that people watch the most, like Family Matters, Buffy, Animaniacs, Hang with Mr. Cooper, Pinky and the Brain, Perfect Strangers, Boy Meets World, Step by Step, Dinosaurs, Home Improvement, My So-Called Life, which is a really good show. Cheers, always his favorite. Wings, Step by Step. I already said Saved by the Bell. So yeah, they do add quite a bit of shows. It's just you have to wait for them to kind of update the monologue and the category sections. So yeah, this is my re-review of Hulu. Everybody have a wonderful day, and I will be back with another review later. Everybody, peace and much love. Bye.